Hi everyone and welcome to HD Piano. My name is Joanna and in today's lesson we're going to learn how to play Mercy by Brett Young. In this part one video I'm going to show you how to play the intro and the verse, and it goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that was the intro and the verse. To check out the remaining sections to this video, don't forget to head on over to hdpiano.com where you can find all of these plus loads of other songs. Okay, so before we dive into this one, I've got a question for you guys. We don't really listen to much country music here in the UK, and so this is kind of a new thing for me. So could you list below your favourite country songs and perhaps list a link to a video? I'd love to go check those out. All right, let's dive in. Here we go. So this song is really just going around the introduction when we head into the verse. So I'm going to show you the intro first and then we'll dive into the verse. We'll go in the order of the song. That makes sense, doesn't it? Okay, so we've got 4 black keys to be careful of in this piece. We've got F sharp, G sharp, and we also have C sharp and D sharps to watch out for. So just remember that as you're playing today, just to be careful of those. We play a lot of these. We're in E major, so we're going to start off with a kind of an E major chord. So here we go. This is the first bit. So we've got 1, 2, 3, and 4, and so my left hand is middle C, my right hand is just underneath middle C, and my left hand is 2 C's down around this kind of area, and I've got that low E on my keyboard, and I'm just going to hold it down while I do this first bar. Okay, so as you can see, I'm playing around this E chord. I've got E, G sharp, and B. And I'm holding down, I'm using the pedal, but I'm also going to be holding down lots of notes. And it helps the sound kind of stay smooth and connected if we kind of hold notes down as we're playing. I'm going to try and hold this E down as I play a lot in this piece. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And can you see how I'm holding this E down while I'm playing the top 2 notes of the chord? 1, 2, 3 and 4, and on the end of 3 and the end of 4, I'm going to play the E again. 1, 2, 3 and 4, and let's do it a few more times. 3 and 4, and 1, 2, 3 and 4, and 1, 2, 3 and 4, and you got the hang of that? Don't forget about the left hand as well. Keep it held down. Okay, here's the next bit. I'm going to move my thumb down and my fingers are going to change. So now my thumb, if you can, hit the B below this C. If not, you can kind of just stay. You can just stay in that E shape. But I'm going to get my thumb down to this B. So here's middle C. The next C down, here's this B. And then my third finger plays the F sharp. And my little finger plays the B. The B on top. So I'm literally just holding that B. The left hand just stays the same. I'm holding that B right until the end of the bar. And playing it 3 times this on top. 4 times, sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, and on the and, then I come up and I'm going to play that E there. 1, 2, 3, 4, and. So let's combine those 2 bars together. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, and 4, and 1, two, three, four, and again. Okay, into the next bar. Keep your thumb there if you can, and then you've got G sharp and B on the top. And we're going to hold this down, similar kind of pattern to the first E chord we played. And then we've got one, two, three, and four. And can you see, actually, I switched to my fourth finger. That might be something that you want to do. If anything's feeling really uncomfortable, just try and switch around a finger here and there and see if that helps. You might have to do it halfway through playing. One, two, three, and four, and that's the third bar. And then we're going to go back to what we did in the second bar. One, two, three, four, and okay, let's combine it all together. Here we go. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, and four, and one, two, three, four, and one, two, three, and four, and one, two, three, four. Let's do it again. And one more time for luck. That's it. That's the intro. Now, the verse is really similar. It's a couple of changes. So I'm just going to talk you through the verse. I won't spend as long a time because you kind of got it now. But we'll talk through any differences between the verse and the chorus. So here we go. That's the verse and the chorus, the intro and the verse. Here we go. So here's the first bit of the verse. One, two, three, four. And one, two, three, four. So on the fourth one, when you get to this one, this chord here, it's actually kind of like an E sus chord. We're gonna go down and we're gonna play the D sharp. So let's do that again. One, two, three, four, and one, two, three, four. And that leads us into the next chord. We're gonna go and play kind of an E chord again. Now my left hand has got a bit more going to it now. Now I'm gonna play C sharp and G sharp. So again, I'm still playing that E chord in the top right hand. I've got one, two, three, four, and one, two, three, four, and. And the other thing that changes here is I go to a C sharp in my right hand now. So I'll just do that again. One, two, three, four, and one, two, three, four, and. Okay, and then I go back to my E chord kind of shape, and my left hand is going even further now. I've got, here's the low C that I was just playing. I've got A and E. I kind of got this A shape here. One, two, three, four, and one, two, three, four, and. So did you see that? It's quite a nice sound. It's really beautiful. So the right hand changes a tiny bit. So you've got the E chord. And then I'm just going to play A and B at the top now. And don't forget that E coming in. One, two, three, four. And one, two, three, four. And one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And one, two, three, and four. And here's another change. So here we go, we've got that pattern again. We've got C sharp at the bottom, F sharp and B. Now I'm going to try and situate my fingers in a different way. I'm going to put my thumb on C sharp, third finger on F sharp, little finger on B. One, two, three, and four, and. Because I'm going to be playing kind of these passing notes between the chords. One, two, three, and four, and. So I've got F sharp, E, and then I got my next chord, D sharp, F sharp, and B, and then to the E again. Mm-hmm. So all together. Two, three, and four, and then here, I'm gonna play, I'll show you with the whole thing. So the right hand is doing this. I've got C sharp, E, G sharp, and B. And then I just play the top bit of the chord. So I'll do it twice. And then here I'm going to switch up. I've got E, A, and B. And then back to my my E chord. And then I'm just playing E, F sharp, B. And then down to the D sharp like that. Here we go. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. One more time. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And my left hand is playing this octave, really low octave A's. So I've got this low A on the first beat. One, two, and. So can you see how it comes up? One, two, and three, and four. And again. One, two, and three, and four. One, two, three, four. And then you just got octave B's at the end. All right, that's it. You've learned the intro and the verse, which is fantastic. So well done. All right, I will see you on over at hdpiano.com, the home of hybrid piano lessons, for the rest of the remaining videos to this song. Don't forget to leave us a comment below, like, and subscribe to us for all the latest songs and videos that we have to show you. And you can find us on all social media as well. Well done, you've just learnt a song with me, Joanna, at hdpiano.com, the home of hybrid piano lessons.